What's up, everyone? John Rettinger from TechnoBuffalo here, and by looking at the setup, I'm guessing you can see that we've got a eReader showdown for you. In one corner, we have the contender, Apple's iPad, and in the other, we have the champion, Amazon's Kindle 2. I do a lot of reading, I'm a big reader, and I've done almost all of my reading, at least for almost the past year, exclusively on the Kindle. So I was very intrigued by the iPad, its potential, and its iBookstore. So we're going to go through the stores and how they look and sort of declare a winner at the end of this. But before we do that, let's get a bit geeky and go over some of the specs. The Kindle 2 has a 6-inch e-ink display, and you can see it's not backlit. It's meant to look like a book or standard print paper. It's got a massive 2-week battery, and it really does last that long. The battery is only being drained actually when the pages are being turned. When it's displaying static content like this or a page, the battery is not being used. And it weighs about 10.3 ounces. It is very light. The iPad has a 9.7-inch backlit LCD. It's a capacitive touchscreen. Battery lasts about 10 hours, and it weighs 1.5 pounds. So with the backlit screen, you've got no need for a light, but you do get a bit of glare and reflection. On the Kindle, on the other hand, you do need a light if you want to read in the dark, but you're not going to get the reflection that you're going to get with the iPad. So again, that's really going to be which one you prefer. Bigger screen real estate, we'll see in a minute, and that does come into play. So let's talk about the bookstores. The iBookstore that Apple just launched has about 60,000 titles, and I'm certain that that will grow. Amazon has a very mature bookstore. that sounded funny. It's been out for a while, it's probably a better way to say that, of about 450,000. Apple uses an open EPUB format for their books, and Kindle uses a proprietary Kindle format. And you might be thinking, great, Apple uses an open format, I can download an EPUB book and do whatever I want, use it on multiple devices. Not true. Apple used an open format and closed it, similar to what they did with AAC and iTunes. So while it's technically an open format, you're still within Apple's walled garden here. So let's take a look at the bookstores on each. We'll go to iBooks. And when it comes to pure eye candy, this is really a no-brainer decision between the iPad or the Kindle. Larger screen, color, can show a lot more. So you're greeted with a shelf, looks like a wood shelf of books. You've got Winnie the Pooh is sort of the free one that comes included. So let me show you what reading a book on here looks like, and then I'll show you the bookstore. So go ahead and open up Pooh. So I was just on one of the pages here. Navigation is pretty simple. At the bottom of the page, you've got that bar, you can move along to any chapter that you'd like. And if you want to turn the page, just as you would, I guess, on a regular book, you can actually flip the page over. And I believe you can just tap the margins too if you want to change a page if you don't want that animation. But you do get it if you like. You sort of get the feel of actually turning a page over. So we'll go and show you some more of the options here. And you can see you get a lot of content on just one page. Now, this does have an accelerometer, so you can turn it any way you like. Now you actually get two pages per screen. Again, you can turn the page, it just says you with anything else. So you get sort of a more book-esque feel. I'm gonna go ahead and put it back into portrait for demonstration purposes. So you can go ahead and go back to your library if you'd like. You can go ahead and view the table of contents and jump right to a particular part. You can view your bookmarks and jump right to them. So we'll go ahead and just pick whatever, chapter two. You can adjust the brightness right from here, and that's actually important. When you're viewing web pages, you may want a brighter screen, but that may also have some eye strain. So if you want to take the brightness down and get sort of a closer feel to what the e-ink looks like, you can actually pull the brightness down right from the display. And the theory behind that is that you'll have less eye strain. Go ahead and put that back up. You can change the font size to whatever size you'd like. You can even pick the font that you'd like. And you can go ahead and search for a particular word. You've got some options for the text as well. You can hold down, you can pick a word, and you can bookmark it, you can search it, you can look for it in a dictionary if you don't know what the word means. And you do get, since it's color, you get sort of the pictures look as they would in an actual book, which is nice if you're reading a story to a child or something. You can actually show them the picture. So let's take a look at the Kindle. Go ahead and push this off to the side. And we'll take a look here at, let's say, Super Freakonomics, one of the books that I'm currently reading. Go ahead and hit OK there. just going to do a little bit of syncing. And that's something to keep in mind as well. The Amazon Kindle has something that's called WhisperNet, which essentially will sync your content amongst all of your Kindle devices, so you'll always be on the same page. Now, reading here, you're going to get pretty much the same options you get if you're reading an actual book. The e-ink display does create very minimal eye strain. Move that off to the side, get a bit distracted. It does create very minimal eye strain. It's really nice, easy format. It is a bit smaller. It's 6-inch screen, so it shows less content. Pages are turned by buttons. And everything is done by buttons. This is not a touchscreen e-ink. Sony, I believe, has a touchscreen one. And all the pages are conducted just by turning and tapping the button. It's a very nice way to read a book. You get sort of a feel of actually reading real text because of the e-ink display. It is quite nice. Now, you do get some menu options and some options as well for customization. If you go ahead and hit menu, you can see what some of those are. You can jump right to the table of contents. You can view the cover. You can go to the beginning, go to your locations. You can sync it, like I just mentioned. You can view the description of the book. You can search this book for a particular word. Add a bookmark, and this also has a built-in dictionary as well, which is nice. Reading a book, you don't know what, I don't know, xenophobic or loquacious means. You go ahead and look it up and you know what that is. As far as customization options, you do get a decent amount of things with the Kindle. It'll read actually the book back to you in a very robotic voice, and you can change the font size as well. This round is really going to have to be a personal preference, whether or not you can deal with the eye strain and the brighter, larger display of the iPad, or that you prefer sort of a more traditional book look of the e-ink. Personally, I like being able to have more text on a page. I like being able to see the images, and the animation sort of appeal to the geek in me. So from a personal standpoint, I prefer the iPad. However, I have not read many, many, many books on this yet, as nearly as I have on the Kindle. So I haven't experienced eye strain. That's something to keep in mind as you do continue to use the device. This one's going to be a personal decision. But for me, it is the iPad. So let's go ahead and check out the bookstores and see what that looks like. So we'll jump back to the library. We'll go ahead and hit store. And you get a very similar store look and feel that you get on the iPad with iTunes or the App Store. So you go ahead and view books. New books here are about $12.99, a bit more expensive actually on the iPad than they are on the Kindle, although they do have very generous previews. So let's pick a book here. We'll go Silent Sea. Opens up, you get a description, you get the ratings, and you get samples. Now, one thing I should say about the samples, they're very generous here. Some samples have even been upwards of 100 pages. Samples on the Kindle, you're generally going to get the first chapter, both of which will give you enough to read and get a sense of whether or not you want to buy the book. But the samples tend to be a bit longer. You can view all the ratings, you can be the first to rate, you can give those typical star ratings, or just go ahead and buy. You can tap that or get sample. Go right to the author's page, or if you want to email the book to a friend. There are a ton of free choices here as well. Go ahead and scroll down. A ton of free books. You go ahead and pick a lot of the classics, actually, that have sort of been floating in the ether for a while. So let's go back to featured, and I'll download a sample and show you what that looks like. So here's the Bullpen Gospels. I'm a baseball fan. So we'll just get the sample. Sort of rotates, and it shows up right on your bookshelf. Tap it, and you can go ahead and start reading it. The same options that we just talked about. Go back to the store. So like I mentioned, you're limited to just about 60,000 titles on the iPad at launch, although Apple has promised that it will grow. And by the time you're watching this video, you know, these two may be at parity, but for right now, the Kindle has a very, very large advantage. So make sure you got some of the search functionality works. I was looking up Super Freakonomics, one of the, again, the books I'm reading now, you saw on the Kindle. Just typed it in, pulled up a suggestion. If they have the book, you get sort of the same options that we just saw before. Go ahead and go back. You can view by featured, New York Times bestsellers. Sort of scroll through all those. Top charts, the top paid books, and whatever purchases that you've made. I certainly don't have any on here yet. So let's push the iPad off to the side and take a look at the Kindle bookstore. So we'll go to back to the home screen. We'll go to menu and we'll shop in the Kindle store. Now it's certainly less elegant, but it's as functional as the iPads. Again, the iPad has a lot of eye candy, which you may or may not like. This is more of, I'd say, traditional ebook, which is funny to say traditional with a very digital format. So you can view, browse by books, newspapers, magazines, or blogs. Same options, New York Times bestseller, Kindle top sellers, and some daily posts, and some books that have been recommended to you based on purchases. So let's go to New York Times bestsellers. Now the iPad, I should mention, uses Wi-Fi. I'm testing the Wi-Fi only version. There will also be a 3G version, which will use AT&T. This version, the Kindle I'm using, is the older Kindle 2, which has Sprint's EVDO Rev A network. Newer versions that are global use AT&T as well, but do not have Wi-Fi, so you're doing just a cellular network. So you go ahead and pick a book. Here's The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. And open that up. And you get some information on it as well. You get customers who bought this also bought. You can get the ratings. And you can go ahead and download a sample. Very similar, like I mentioned, the samples are just about a chapter long. And search works just the same. Type Super Freakonomics again. And this does have a full on-screen keyboard. The iPad uses a virtual keyboard. Here you've got actual buttons, which some people tend to prefer. Go ahead and search the store. And it will pull it up, and I can go ahead and buy that. Now, the options for reading the books and what the home screen looks like, it's just a grid view. You can go ahead and pick the book you want, tap in the D-pad, and it opens it right up like you saw there with Super Freakonomics. So when it comes down to the bookstore, having more books is better than having, I think, a prettier bookstore to look at. So I think the Kindle's got to win that just based on sheer number. Now, if the iPad ever reaches parity as far as number of titles, having the eye candy may be nice. So right now we're about tied up. You know, it's again going to be personal preference whether or not you prefer the larger screen of the iPad or the smaller e-ink of the Kindle. But there is a big, big, big trump card here when it comes down to deciding which ebook reader you want to get. And that is right here, the Kindle app. Amazon has released a Kindle app for the iPad, essentially giving the iPad access to every book in the Kindle bookstore. And takes advantage of its Whisper Sync network, so your books are always sunk up. You can download and buy any book that you can on the Kindle right here on the iPad. So here is a Super Freakonomics we were just talking about. And I get that now. For this location, go ahead and no. And I can go ahead and scroll through pages. I don't get the same animations, but I can jump right to the next page as I could on the Kindle. Except now I've got a bigger screen to look at it. And I've got access to, again, all those same books. Let me show you again something about the Kindle app. We'll go ahead and shop in the Kindle store, and it's gonna go ahead and launch the browser. It's gonna take me to Amazon.com, where essentially I can buy any book that I want in Amazon's native format. And for me, this is an absolute killer application. Not only do I get access to Apple's iBookstore and sort of all the cool graphics, I also get access to Amazon's entire catalog and every book they have. So if I can't find something in Apple's 60,000 catalog, I can certainly find it in Amazon's 450,000 catalog. You have just so many more choices here with the iPad. If you can deal with the backlit screen, you can take the brightness down to decrease your eye strain. This one really is a no-brainer. The iPad is clearly the better choice, in my opinion, for an e-reader. Now, something to keep in mind as well, it does weigh 1.5 pounds, so it can get a bit heavy while holding. If you want to sit on the couch and put it on your knees, not a problem, or read it in bed. If you are going to hold it, the 1.5 pounds can weigh a little bit more than you may like. So guys, this has been John Rettinger with a head-to-head of probably what I assume are going to be the two most popular ebook readers on the market, the Apple iPad and the Kindle 2. And in addition to just being able to read all the books here, the iPad gives you a lot of other things, Safari and Mail and a ton of other things that I've covered in previous videos. So guys, I'm John Rettinger from TechnoBuffalo, and for all your iPad news, tips, and tricks, be sure to check out the channel at TechnoBuffalo.com, where you can make your own tech website, interact with people, and even make a few bucks by putting in your own ad code. Anyway guys, if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, I'd appreciate it. I'm John Rettinger, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.